it is absolutely not going to happen, but everybody is talking about it, which is why we're going to talk about it too. Now, Kirill Kaprizov was a guy that the Minnesota Wild were waiting for, and they waited so goodness graciously gosh darn long for this guy to actually come over onto their squad. He was drafted all the way back in 2015 in the McDavid draft, which also featured so many good players in the first round, but Kaprizov was taken in the fifth round. And ever since then, Wild fans have been excited because year after year in the KHL and the Olympics and the World Championships and the World Juniors, all these tournaments, they had themselves a very fundamentally strong, skilled, offensive dynamo of a hockey player who could just go out there and put up point after point after point. Now he made his debut this season, signing over with the team a year ago in the bubble. Unfortunately, he was not able to be used in the bubble because of some weird whatever was going on over there, but he made his debut in 2020-2021, where he put up 27 goals, 51 points in 55 games played, just under a point per game, and it's not like this guy is super old. I mean, he's 24, so it's around the same age that Artemi Panarin was when he took the Calder from McDavid and Gostisbehere all those years ago, but that's besides the point. Kirill Kaprizov signed a two-year contract, one for 2019-20, which was actually signed in the summer of last year. It didn't do anything. He didn't play in the bubble or whatever because of that thing we were talking about. But he signed a contract that ended this season. He doesn't have a contract currently for 2021-2022, and he's currently what is defined by Cap Friendly as a 10.2C player. He's a player who has become a free agent when his contract expired on July 1 after the last league year of his contract, and he doesn't meet the UFA requirements or the Group 2 RFA requirements displayed in the table above, which is over here. Yeah, it's this stuff. He's not technically an RFA, but he's a guy who needs to negotiate a contract only with the Wild right now. He can't get signed to an offer sheet, he can only sign with the Wild, also he's not eligible for arbitration. What happened yesterday was quite big, because we had Kevin Weeks. Yes, he is the NHL Network guy, former goaltender, and a guy who was interviewed for a whole bunch of GM jobs earlier in this year. He made a tweet that kind of went viral, and it got a whole bunch of people up in arms kind of freaking out. As of now, the talks with Rookie of the Year, likely Rookie of the Year, Kirill Kaprizov and the Minnesota Wild have gone cold. My understanding is he's in Moscow, and it's believed that CSKA Moscow is interested in signing him for the KHL and the Olympics. And you know what? This came out and everybody was kind of freaking out. Yo, are you serious? Kirill Kaprizov might go back to the KHL? Let's take a second and hypothetically think, okay, what if that actually happens? You have a guy who comes into the NHL, he's under a point per game, and he wins the Calder. Has that ever happened before, where a Calder winner just straight up yeets out to another league after he wins the Calder? Like, I mean, I'm here looking at the Calder list, Cale Makar, Pedersen, Barzal, Matthews. None of these guys would have done that, right? They're all active in the NHL right now. You gotta scroll down even further. Scott Gomez, Samsonov, Brian Berard. Okay, these guys all played in the NHL long term. Is there even a moment where the Rookie of the Year yeets off to another league after he wins the Rookie of the Year in the NHL? Is that even a thing? That's only if it actually happens, though, right? I mean, there's got to be some reason why Kirill Kaprizov is over here and why Kevin Weeks is talking about it. Like, you know, the CSKA Moscow team that he played for before is interested in signing him for the KHL and the Olympics. Well, we had ourselves another tweet coming out from Michael Russo, the Minnesota Wild insider. He is the scribe for The Athletic. This is what he posted a few hours after that original Kevin Weeks tweet. The Minnesota Wild and Kirill Kaprizov's agents say that Kaprizov is at his buddy's wedding in Moscow. His agent gave the team a heads up. As for the CSKA Moscow rumors, that's his only option besides signing with the Wild, and they'll offer him a ton of money, so expect those rumors as long as he is unsigned here. As far as negotiations with the Wild, Kaprizov wants short-term so far. The Wild has offered him long-term, so as I've reported, this is going to be a tough negotiation. Again, the Russian option is the only other option, so that will be the leverage as long as he is unsigned. And it is something that we have heard from all the insiders earlier, that the Wild are indeed offering Kaprizov a max 8-year deal. Now, I don't really know if we had anybody actually give out the number, oh, it's gonna be 8x8 or 8x9 or 8x10 or whatever, but like, take a look at this guy. 24 years old. He comes to the NHL. He leads his team in points with 51 in 55 games played. It's not even close. Kevin Fiala has 40. This is Artemi Panarin, but like on steroids. This guy is Artemi Panarin without Patrick Kane, who still dominated his team in the same way that Artemi Panarin did. Panarin had 77 points in 80 games played when he made his debut with the Blackhawks. Kaprizov, kind of in that same point per game range. And you take a look at how Panarin has developed. He is one of the best players in the league, an arguable heart guy. And Kaprizov's like, hey, I mean, I'm 24 years old right now, doing really well. I'm a good hockey player. I could go out there and get some money. Why wouldn't he ask for a short-term deal? It's very easy to see why the Wild would be like, okay, here's 8 years by $8 million. Please sign now, because by the time you're 27, 28, 29 years old, you'll be a lot more expensive than that. But everybody kind of knows what's going on here, right? I mean, Kaprizov, I guess he kind of knows his own worth, and we all kind of know how good we think he's going to be in the future. So it's within his right, I guess, to say, all right, well, I'm going to go and ask for a short-term contract, because if I get like 2 years at $8 million and all of a sudden I get 100 points in a season, I'm going to want to up that contract to maybe $10, $11 million. Come on, Mitch Marner's making something like 10.8 whatever. He's a top-paid winger in the league. He doesn't score any goals in the playoffs. I do. So when it comes to the KHL coming in here, you know, firstly, I think that him being in Moscow for a wedding is like a completely moot point. Like, we don't even care if he's there for a wedding, for an anniversary, or for a family thing. He's in there, he's there because he's doing other stuff. It's not hockey related. As for the CSKA thing, it's like, duh, if he's out there and he has the option to sign with a KHL team, I'm sure KHL teams would be knocking on this guy's door. Same with any other team in any other league. Hey, he's a free agent. Do your homework and try to get this guy playing for us, because if he has the ability to sign a contract here, we could use this kind of guy. I would not be surprised if teams in the SHL, in the Liga, in the NLA, in the Extra Liga were knocking on this guy's door, phoning him up, saying, hey, you know, you're a free agent. You want to play hockey in Belarus? You want to play hockey in Latvia? You want to come to our team? We could use a guy like you. If you're not going to sign with Minnesota, hey, we've got a lot of money over here. You want to come over here, right? 1-2 year contract, do your thing. Like, it's obviously going to happen like that. Kirill Kaprizov, the fact that he's even in this state where he can only sign with the Wild or any team outside of the NHL, puts him in a position where it's like, of course CSKA would want this guy. He's out here as a guy who used to play for them. In fact, this entire Russian angle, I think, is probably just going to be used as leverage in order to tell the Wild, look, if you don't want to pay me a short-term deal, which is what I want, I'm going to take my behind over to Russia, because they're going to do exactly that. They're going to pay me 200 million rubles for 2 years, and then I'm going to come back because, hey, that money plus whatever I could get on a contract soon is better than what you're offering me now for 8 years. You see where it's coming from, right? Athletes got to get paid, especially ones like Kirill Kaprizov, where if he becomes like a top 10, top 7, top 5 point producer in this league, it wouldn't be too surprising to me. So, talk to me in the comments what you think about this entire thing. I, for one, don't buy it. I think it's just going to be used as leverage here. I think for sure he'll stay with Minnesota. It's just debatable as to whether or not what kind of contract it's going to be. Kevin Weeks just kind of decided to get the hockey world up in flames with that little tweet insinuating that, hey, there is a possibility that the guy who was so dominant, the guy whom we have been waiting for so long to step into the NHL, might have just passed his expiration date in this league. Again, I don't buy it, but hey, talk to me in the comments what you think. I hope you enjoyed this Rumours 99, and bye.